Well, good morning. My name is Doug Dienerman, and I'm with the Minnesota Department of Natural Resources, Section of Fisheries. And today we're at Trout Run in extreme southwest Winona County. And we're doing a typical population assessment for primarily for brown trout, but certainly for all fish species. And this happens to be one of our long-term resource monitoring streams, where we actually do this one every single year to really keep very close tabs on how the trout populations fluctuate from year to year, and specifically what are some of the environmental factors that change from year to year that are influencing those fish populations.
My name is Vaughn Snook. I'm the Assistant Supervisor at the Lanesboro DNR Fisheries Office. We're doing a stream assessment today, and this is our biggest barge electrofisher. We have it rigged right now with two anodes and a remote cathode. So we have a cathode with multiple rings on it that I'm moving here right now. That's the negative part of the circuit. The single ring to my right is the anode. That's the positive part of the circuit. Fish are repulsed by the cathode. So I can put the cathode in a log jam or a big pile of weeds or whatnot, and they'll shoot out of that and be attracted or pulled. Involuntarily swim to the anode, the positive part of the circuit. And then once they're to the anode, the netter can net them.
The electrofishing sampling is just about completed, and we're starting to work up our fish. And what we do is one of the first things we do is take lengths and weights on all the fishes that we get, so we can get an estimate of not only the numbers of fish population estimates, but their size as well. Obviously anglers are pretty interested in size of fish. We take the weights because we can use the weights in conjunction with the lengths to get an idea of their condition, how plump they are. Obviously healthier populations tend to have fish that tend to be more plump. In addition to the lengths and weights, we're also doing some tagging with passive integrated transponder tags or pit tags. This fish, Melissa, is a length of 3.5 inches, and he weighs 0.02. So after we get our length and weight, we take a pit tag, which Melissa has loaded into our needle here, and we insert that into the dorsal musculature in the back, like so. Just squeeze on the end of the hypodermic needle, pushes the tag up into the dorsal musculature and into the muscle. And you got a pit tag number already?
Yep.
Okay. And then we also give it an external mark by clipping the adipose fin, so that when the fish is recaptured, hopefully next year or in 2 years, we'll be able to identify that that's a tagged fish, because we typically handle hundreds of fish when we're doing this. So this way it gives us a clue to look just for the adipose clipped ones, and then we can scan it to see how big they are and how much they've grown over the last year. Or hopefully we'll recapture them in consecutive years, 2-3 years down the road, so we can see how much they're growing at their different ages.